Okay, now we have this three module LM2596 DC-DC buck converter. Only this module is okay. This one is good and this two is faulty, but I don't know which component is faulty. Maybe the main chip LM2596, maybe another component. But we can see that in this module here is a diode missing. Okay, this diode is missing. Here is also a capacitor missing, and also we can see that here is a resistor, but there is nothing in here. A lot of components are missing in this unit. Now we are going to see, what about this one? This one have the diode and the resistor too. Capacitor is also in its place. At first we'll check our main component, main IC. I unassembled it with my hot air gun. This one and this one. I don't know which one is good. Maybe two of them are good, maybe not. So we're going to check it with our multimeter. Multimeter in continuity mode. At first we'll see this one, how it works. So I think this one is negative. So now I'm trying to see the good one. Here is one proof and here is one. Number one pin is not short. This one, it shows some resistance. It's short, so it's not. It also shows some resistance. This one is short. So we found the good one has third and fifth leg short with negative. And this one, first leg is short. It's very bad because we know that this good IC is not short in first leg. Then second is not short. 127 ohms, but this one is 1645 ohms. Maybe it's connected to the board. Let's move. Third pin short. It's okay. Fourth not short. Fifth not short, but fifth is short. Okay, this one is not act as like good one. So we have another chip. Let's check it out. Number one not short. Number two 1500 ohm, almost same as the good one. Third pin short, same as good one. Fourth pin not short. Fifth pin short as like good one. So we can say that our this chip is good and this one is not good. So we have one good chip and two board. This chip was in this board, but this board has three missing components: one capacitor, one diode, and one resistor. So keep it here. This faulty IC was in this board, but except the IC, nothing is missing. I think all other components are okay. So components are okay. So we're going to, this one is misplaced because of my hot air gun. So I will solder it again in right position and solder this IC in this board. I think it will work and we'll have a working buck converter again. First we have to clean this thing with some cotton pad and thinner. I think it's nice and clean now. Soldering iron is ready to work. Let's try to clean this counter. Working with SMD is still challenging for me. I'm learning. Now I will use my hot air gun. I think it will work. Remove the chip in the board, then install it again. Apply some hot air. Now it's okay. Then time to install our chip. Apply some soldering paste. It will help our soldering process. I think we made a solid solder joint. Now check that all the pin are solid. So my god, they're hot. I removed extra solder. I think it's okay and it's ready to work. Now we have to check everything. First we have to clean our desk. Now it's time to clean the thing. Clean the extra lid. There is some problem in board. The strip is ripped, but it's okay, it will work. Now it's not works. Now it's okay. Is positive in, negative output, positive out. Let's input some voltage. 10 volt positive input. First, what's the problem? There is an LED and it's not glowing. This one is good and the light is glowing. 40 board and no LED. We're trying to fix this one. Try it again. Positive in LED. Let's see, is there any voltage in output? No, it is not. Looks like everything is okay, but still not working. Where is the problem? I desoldered these two capacitors from the board and check with my multimeter. It shows that the capacitor is okay, but one other thing, that here is a tiny capacitor, SMD capacitor, and it works weird, not as like the good one. So I'm going to replace this capacitor with this one. This one looks good. The capacitor is replaced, but I've done a very bad job. First, our potentiometer, our pot resistor is burnt outside. You see, it's purple now, but still no sign of life. I think our soldering was not good enough. No, it's not possible with soldering iron. Let's try to use our hot air gun again, now with some extra caution. I think now it's solid. Now let's inject voltage again. Input negative, input positive. No, still no sign of life. Let's remove this what we put gun from the bottom. Detail heat up our solder joint and first AD caps. Fine. Actually, these modules are very cheap and it's not worth it to repair it. But I'm doing it because I am learning to work with SMD modules. Still, it's not working. I don't know. Maybe the chip is bad actually. I have only one way to confirm it. If I can install this chip in this good unit, then I will understand that what is the actual problem. Is this IC okay or not? But I'm not doing this because it's a cheap module, less than $1, and I already give it too much time. 10.6 2.77 gold is 10.1 and it's not good. The good module saw this one, and this one has 0.78 volt, and this one shows the exact volt I input here. 10.63 10.63. That's not good. What's the problem? I think the IC is not good actually. So this is all for today, and we can say it's a no fix, but we learned something. At first I burned this port, and then I replace this one almost without burning. It's improvement. Thank you for your time. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe, like, share and comment. Your support is important for me.